तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमः ॐ विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्यधीशधारिणे। पञ्चकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासति गौर भक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So we're going through the sixth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, and today we're beginning chapter 4.
我们继续学习圣典波迦瓦坛的第六篇，今天我们将学习第四章。
And it's entitled the Hamsaguya prayers offered by Prajapati Daksha.
这章的标题是 Prajapati Daksha 供奉给主 Hamsaguya 的祷文。
So the chapter begins with Maharaj Parikshit putting a request to Sukadeva Goswami.
在这章开始, Maharaj Parikshit 向 Sukadeva Goswami 提了一个问题。
And so he says to Sukadeva Goswami that during the time of Swayambhuva Manu, when Swayambhuva Manu was the first Manu in the day of Brahma, so during that time there were many different species of life created.
在 Swayambhuva Manu 这个时期, Swayambhuva Manu 是 Brahma 一天的第一个 Manu, 在他的
在这个时期有很多种类的生物诞生出来。Right, in one day of Brahma, there are 14 Manus.
在Brahma的一天有14位Manu.
And the first Manu in this day of Brahma was Swayambhuva Manu.
在这一天的第一个Manu是Swayambhuva Manu.
Now we're in the reign of Vaivashvata Manu. He's like the seventh Manu.
我们现在在Vaivashvata Manu是在第七个Manu的这个时间段。Alright,
so during Swayambhuva Manu, there were he created demigods and demons and human beings.
在这个Swayambhuma这个期间，他创造了半神人、恶魔、人类，还有其他一些。And
he created also birds and beasts. Snakes, these kind of things.
他还创造了鸟，还有走兽以及蛇等等这些生物体。So
Maharaj Parikshit says to Sukadeva Goswami, he said, "You told me about this in the third canto."
Maharaj Parikshit 跟 Sukadeva Goswami 说，你在第三篇的时候曾经给我讲述过一些。
But you told me only about it very briefly. I want you to tell me about it more elaborately.
但是您之前讲的比较简要，现在我想听您更详细的讲解一下。And
I also want to know about how the Supreme Lord, how he did the secondary creation.
而且我还想知道至尊人格首神他的第二重创造是怎样的。Right,
there are two phases to the creation, the primary creation and the secondary creation.
有两重创造,有第一重创造,有第二重的创造。So
the primary creation is done by the Supreme Lord through Mahavishnu, and he creates, for example, he creates first of all Garbhodakshayi Vishnu and then Shirodakshayi Vishnu.
第一重创造是 Mahavishnu 创造，他创造了
And he creates the different elements of the material creation.
而且他创造了整个创造你所需要的这些不同的元素。
Then the secondary creation is done by Lord Brahma.
第二重创造是由主 Brahma 所做的。
So we see Maharaj Parikshit, he wants to hear about the secondary creation.
所以我们在这里看到 Maharaj Parikshit, 他想聆听有关第二重的创造。
So Sukadeva Sutta Goswami is speaking now. Sutta Goswami is speaking. That means he's speaking to the sages in Naimasharanya.
这个时候 Sutta Goswami 又说了，他所在的是他在 Naimasharanya 森林里面跟那些圣人们准备说话。And
he's telling the sages in Naimasharanya what Sukadeva Goswami said to Maharaj Parikshit.
他是在南米舍人亚森林给大家转述到底马哈拉吉，舒克德瓦 Goswami 给 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述了一些什么。
So he tells us, he said, Sukadeva Goswami began by talking about the 10 sons of Prachinibari.
舒克德瓦 Goswami 现在就开始讲关于 Prachinibari 的10个儿子。
Right, they're called the Prachetas.
他们被称为 Prachetas.
So they had gone into the ocean, they'd gone into the bottom of the ocean to do meditation.
他们到海底里面去做冥想.
Right, they were doing, it was a austerity they were doing.
他们也是在那里做一些苦行.
And the idea, you know, in the past, in the Satya Yuga and Treta Yuga, Before marriage, the young men would go and do some austerity first before they got married.
在以前的金器银器年代的时候，在年轻的男子他要结婚之前，这些年轻的男子他们会去做一些苦行.
Even today, in some countries, you'll see young men, they may become a Buddhist monk for some time before marriage.
即便是在今天，有一些国家，有一些人他在结婚之前，我们会看到他是一个年，他在结婚之前曾是一个年轻的僧侣。They
will become a monk and they will live by begging for a few months or even a year, and it's a preparation for entering into married life, family life.
他在进入到居士和婚姻生活之前。 他会想去当一个和尚去乞讨，他做这些活动是为了去为这个居士婚姻生活做准备。
Prabhupada often said that married life is like going to a feast but fasting.
圣帕帕德也讲，也比喻到婚姻生活，就是说你见到一个大餐，但是呢，你要戒食。
So in family life, married life, there's always an opportunity for sense gratification, and one has to be able to control his senses.
在家庭生活之中，很容易就能够得到感官享乐，但是居士他应该有能力去控制自己的感官。So
before married life, it's advisable to first of all do some austerity and purify oneself.
因此，在进入到居士家庭生活之前，很明智的做法是他应该净化一下自己。Just
like
从事一些苦行，净化一下自己。Just
like before brahmachari, before grihastha life, there is brahmachari life. So first one should be trained as a brahmachari, and then he can go on to become a householder.
就像在 grihastha 居士生活之前，他有通常会有一个 brahmachari。 的生活阶段，真守身的阶段，在真守身的阶段，他得到训练之后，再进入到居士生活。So
the Prachetas, they had gone into the ocean, they'd gone into the bottom of the sea to do their austerity.
所以这些 Prachetas 他去到海洋底下去做苦行。And
when they finished their austerity, they came out from the water. They were surprised to see that all the surface of the land was all covered by trees.
当他们从海底的苦行结束，从海底出来之后，他发现整个地球的这个表，整个地面完全被这些树木所覆盖了。
So the Prachetas, these 10 men, their father, he was fond of doing Vedic sacrifices and killing animals in a Vedic sacrifice.
Pracheta 的父亲，他在做伟大的动物的祭祀仪式。
But Narada Muni was very kind to him, and he told him to stop this killing of the animals.
但是 Narada Muni 对他非常仁慈，他告诉这个国王，就是 Pracheta 的父亲，不要停，就是停止去做这种祭祀仪式。
And Narada Muni got, by his association, this Prachinibari, the father of the Prachetas, he understood Narada Muni, and he left the kingdom and went to the forest to do austerity.
Prachinibari 就是 Pracheta 的父亲，他领会了 Narada Muni 的意思，于是就离开了国家，去到森林里面去苦行。
But when he left to go to the forest, at that time his 10 sons were still in the ocean doing their meditation, doing their tapasya.
但是当他去森林苦行的时候，他的十个儿子又刚好在水底进行苦行，在做他们的苦行。
So that meant there was nobody there to be the king to take charge of the planet.
这就意味着在整个国家没有国王来进行管理。
And so when the Prachetas came out from the ocean, from the water, when they finished their austerity, they saw all trees had grown everywhere.
所以当 Pracheta 从水底出来之后，他发现这个地球的表面全部都是树。
Just like if people don't do farming, if they don't take care of the land to grow food,then the trees will just grow everywhere.
就像农民他如果种田的这个人，他如果不好好的照顾他的土地的话，这个土地上全部都是会长满草啊、树啊之类的。
Now some trees are useful because they provide fruit and flowers.
当然有一些树它是很有用处的，它可以产花，也可以产水果。
But there, a lot of other trees, they're of no use.
但是其他的一些树基本就没有什么用处了。
So some of the, like that kind of trees, the trees which are no use, they can be used as fuel. They can be cut and used for fuel.
而那些没有必要的这些树，它们可以被用来作为燃料。
And that land can be cleared and people can use it to grow food.
而那一块土地就可以被清理，人们可以用那块土地种，种植。
But if the government is not in good hands, if it's not properly managed, then people will not produce food.
如果政府比较忽视这一块的话，人们的产量也会减，种植的这些农作物的产量也会减少。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes it's the duty of the Vaishyas. The Vaishyas' duty is to protect the cows and to farm the land and produce food.
在薄伽梵歌主 Krishna 讲到 Vaishya 的这个本性， Vaishya 的本性和职责就是保护奶牛以及农耕。
So the government, they're like the Kshatriyas.And their duty is to see that the Vaishyas do their duty to produce the food.
政府就相当于是Kshatriya管理部门，而他们的职责就是去监察这些Vaishya是否在履行他们Vaishya的职责。
Right. The Kshatriyas, the managers, the government, they give protection, they protect the people.
Kshatriya, 他们是为了保护人类。
And the Vaishyas, they protect the animals, especially cows.
Vaishya, 这些从商的人，他们是保护动物，尤其是奶牛。
So when the Prachetas came out from the water, they'd been in the water in the bottom of the ocean a long time, And they, when they came out and saw the trees, they were angry.
因为这些 Pacheta 们在 水底做了很长时间的苦行，所以当他们从水里面出来的时候，他发现了太多的树木，而且他还变得非常愤怒起来。
And so just by their desire, they desired that they could burn all the trees to ashes.
只是他们的这种欲望就把这些所有的树木都燃成了灰烬。
So just from their mouth, fire and wind came out, and it burned all the trees.
而从他们的嘴里就产生了风和火，燃烧了所有的树。
So because these Pachetas, they'd done this austerity, so they developed these mystic powers.
因为 Pachetas 们做了很大量的苦行，所以他们发展出他们的神秘的力量。
So a devotee also will do also austerity, he will also do some austerity, but they should never become angry.
奉献者也会做一些苦行，但是他们不应该发展出愤怒。
Devotees should always have good qualities.
奉献者应该总是具有优良的品质。
And one of the qualities which they should have is that they can forgive people.
而其中一个品质就是他们能够原谅他人。
So,Even the devotee may be put into difficulty, but he should not become angry.
即便奉献者处于很困难的处境之中，他也不应该愤怒。
But if somebody does tapasya, but they don't become a Vaishnava, if they don't become a devotee, then they won't develop the good qualities.
如果一个人他经历很多的苦行，但却不成为一个 Vaishnava 或奉献者的话，他不会培养出优良的品质。
Just like Hiranyakashipu and Ravana, they did great austerities, but they were not devotees.
就像 Hiranyakashipu, Ravana, 他们也从事过很大量的苦行，但他们仍然不是奉献者。
They were demons and they wanted to get demonic powers.
他们都是恶魔，而且都想得到这些恶魔的力量。
So devotees, because we're preaching Krishna consciousness, we have to meet many different people who are maybe not always favorable to Krishna consciousness.
一个奉献者由于他在做很多的传播 Krishna 知觉的运动，所以他会遇到很多不同种类的人。
But Lord Chaitanya teaches us that when we preach to people, we shouldn't become angry with them.
我们也可在传播 Krishna 知觉，这些奉献人有可能会遇到一些对 Krishna 不那么感兴趣或者说不友好的人。但是主 Chaitanya 告诉我们，不应该对这些人感到愤怒。
Right? Lord Chaitanya taught us to be humble, like tolerant like the tree, and to offer all respects to others.
主柴坦尼亚告诉我们要要比大树一样还要宽容，总是对别人致以敬意。
And offer all respect, not want any respect for yourself.
即便他人对我不那么尊敬，我们也应该尊敬他人。
So if we want to be preach, if we want to preach the message of Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya,We must be very humble and we must be very tolerant like a tree.
如果我们真想传播主柴坦尼亚的讯息，我们应该要像大树一样去宽容。
Then we can preach the glories of Lord Krishna without any problem.
这样我们才能够毫无困难地去传播 Krishna 之觉。
So,There's a demigod in charge of the trees. He's like the king of the trees, and his name is Soma.
有一个半神人，他管理着所有的树木，他的名字叫 Soma.
He's also the moon god.
他同时也是月神。
So when he saw the fire and wind burning all the trees to ashes, he felt very sad.
当他看到所有的树木都被燃尽成灰的时候，他非常的悲伤。
Because he thought all of these trees, there's so many, they're so valuable, and they have so many herbs, they have so many good things to give us.
他觉得这些树木都非常的有价值，而且能够给一些草药等等，他觉得都有他们自身的价值所在。
So Soma, the moon god, he thought how to get the potatoes to give up this anger.
Soma, 他想让 Pachetas 放弃他们的愤怒。
So we should understand here that the God of the Moon, he maintains all the trees and the plants throughout the universe.
我们从这里可以看到 Soma, 他掌管着整个宇宙的树木。
And it's due to the moonlight that the trees and the plants grow very nicely.
而且在夜晚的时候，月亮升起的时候，这些树木、植物，它们都能够得到很好的生长。
So Prabhupada said, there must be many trees and plants on the moon planet.
圣帕帕德以此推测，在月亮之上一定会有很多的树木。
To say that the moon planet is just dust, it's not logical.
所以说树月球之上只是沙漠，这并不符合逻辑。
So the moon god, he is also the king of not only the trees, but also the vegetables and plants.
这个月神他不仅仅是月亮之神，他还是树木、植物、蔬菜的主宰神邸。
So do you think he would have no plants and trees on his own planet? There must be many.
所以你会认为一个能够掌管植物蔬菜的这个国王 他的国家里面会没有植物和蔬菜吗？
So Soma the moon god began to speak to the Prachetas.
于是 Soma 就准备跟 Prachetas 谈。
And he told them, he said, you're very fortunate, you ten men, you're very fortunate.But you should not kill these poor trees by burning them to ashes.
Soma 就跟 Prachetas 说，你们都是非常幸运的人，但是你们不应该去杀死这些可怜的树木，把它们燃烧成灰烬。
You have a duty to the citizens and to protect them.
你们有职责去保护这些城市的人们。
And to provide them all kinds of prosperity.
而且为他们提供各种各样的所需。
So the government, their duty is not only to protect the people, but all the living entities, including the trees and the animals.
一个政府或国王，他不仅要保护人民，他还要保护所有的动物以及。植物、树木。
No living entity should be killed unnecessarily.
所有的生物都不应该遭到不必要的屠杀、宰杀。
So the Supreme Lord, he is the Lord of all the living entities, including even Brahma and the Prajapatis.
至尊人格守神，他是一切 Prajapati。包括除 Brahma 在内的所有生物体的主人。
So he created all these trees and vegetables as food for other living entities.
他创造了所有的这些树木、植物、蔬菜，是为了其他生物作为他们的食物。
So if the potatoes, if they're going to kill all these trees and all the plants,Then there will be no food for the people.
如果这些 Prachetas 把这些所有的树木、植物全部都燃烧成灰烬的话，那么对其他生物而言，他们就没有食物了。
Yeah, all these trees and plants, they provide food for other living entities.
所有这些树木、植物都其实是给其他生物体，也是他们的一种食物。
So fruit and flowers are also the food for different birds and insects.
不同的水果还有鲜花是不同的这些鸟儿等等其他一些昆虫等等这些生物的食物。
And the four-legged animals like the cows and the buffalo, they will eat the grass.
母牛或者水牛这样四条腿的动物，它们吃草。
And animals, some animals can't use their front legs as hands. They're like food for the animals like tigers.
像那些不能把前面两只腿当成手的这些动物，它们这些动物是老虎的食物。
The tigers have claws, so they can eat these animals.
这个老虎它有爪子，它可以吃掉这些食物，这些动物。
And then you have four-legged animals like the deer and the goats.
还有像鹿和羊这样的四条腿的动物。
They can be food for people, some people who like to eat animal meat.
他们是那些一些想要吃肉的这些人的食物。
And they can also, but they can also eat food grains.
而且人也可以吃五谷。
Mm-hmm.
五谷也是人类的食物。
Yeah, we say one living entity is food for another.
一个生物是另外一个生物的食物。
Four-legged animals are eatables for human beings.
那些四条腿的某一些动物也是其他人类的食物。
So those are animals like the goats and deers, but not cows. Cows have to be protected.
像鹿和羊之类的这些动物，但并不是母牛。
So some people like the Brahmanas, they won't eat meat. Even Kshatriya and Vaishyas also, they may not eat meat.
社会中比较高阶层的人，比如说 Brahmana、Kshatriya 和 Vaishya， 他们不会吃肉。
But some Kshatriyas go to the forest. They hunt. They will hunt animal like the deer, because they have to learn how to kill.
有些时候 ，Kshatriya 到森林里面去打猎的时候，他会吃鹿，因为他必须学习如何搏击杀人的这种。
So when they kill the animal like that, then they have to eat it.
当他在这个时候去杀动物的时候，他可以吃。
And Sudras, sometimes we see Sudras, they like to eat animals, so they can eat goats, but not cows.
Sudra 有些时候他们也喜欢吃动物，但是他们只吃羊，不吃母牛。
If somebody kills a cow, then they will suffer for every hair on the body of the cow.
如果有人吞母牛的话，他会遭受很多的痛苦。这些痛苦，母牛的身上有多少的汗毛，他就得遭受多少的痛苦。
The people want to eat meat, then they have to eat the lower animals, but they should never eat the cow, because the cow is the highest animal.
如果人特别想吃肉的话，他也可以去吃一些低等生物的肉，但是千万不要吃母牛。
The cow provides milk, and milk is very important for the human.
奶牛产牛奶，这个对人类来说是非常重要的。
So it's the duty of the Vaishya to arrange the food for everybody else through their farming and through the cow protection.
Vaishya 阶层通过保护奶牛和农耕，他们为整个社会提供食物。
They provide everything for the people.
他们为人提供所有的这些食物。
So Soma tells these 10 men, the Prachetas, he said, your father and also the Supreme Lord Krishna, they have ordered you to create population.
他们说到你们的父亲 Pachinaba 和智者人格守神命令你们繁衍后代。
So you should not burn these trees.
你们不应该燃烧这些树木。
Because these trees are needed for the maintenance of the people and for their offspring. For they will need these trees.
这些树木植物，它们可以维系你的臣民，甚至维系到你的后代。
And your father and grandfather, they always maintained the people. And they maintained also the animals and the trees also.
你们的父亲、祖父、曾祖父，他们都维系，他们都曾维系着人们、动物，还有这些植物们。
It's not your duty to get so angry, so you should control your anger.
你们的职责不应该，你们的职责不是要变得愤怒，你们应该控制自己的愤怒。
So we see the example of the great kings that they would always do. They were very pious and they would be concerned to maintain all the citizens in their kingdom.
我们可以看到他的整个家族，整个国王，前代的这些国王们。他们都是非常虔诚的人，他们维系着所有的臣民。
And they would maintain not only the humans, but the animals, and even species lower than the animals would be given protection.
他们不仅维系着这些动物们，甚至维系着比动物更低等的这些生物，他们也维系着他们。
In the modern times, we have democracy, and the leaders of democracy, democratic countries,They just take the power from them for themselves.
我们现在有民主的制度，但是这些民主制度的这些领导人，他们只是为他们自身而奋斗。
They don't care about other people.
他们不在乎其他人。
But when you have a good king, then he cares about everyone in the kingdom.
如果有一位非常好的国王的话，他会照顾整个国家里面的所有人。
So Soma is telling the Pratetas about their great fathers and ancestors in their family, how they were very great men.
Soma 在这里告诉 Pratetas， 告诉他的祖先、他的父亲、他的祖先们是多么的伟大。
Then Soma gives some example.He gives an example. He said, just like the father and mother are the friends and maintainers of their children.
Soma 在这里还举了一些例子，就像父亲和母亲又是子女的朋友，又是他们的维系者。
And then he gives another. He said, just like the eyelid protects the eye.
就像睫毛是眼睛的保护者。
And the husband maintains and protects a woman.
一个丈夫是他妻子的保护者和维系者。
And somebody who is a householder, he maintains and protects beggars.
居士他是乞丐的保护者和维系者。
And somebody who is educated and learned, he will be friendly to the ignorant.
博学者，那些受过教育的人，他们是愚昧者的朋友。
In the same way, the king is a protector and giver of life to all of the people in his kingdom.
国王是这些国家里面所有人的保护者和赡养者。
So these trees are also subjects. They are also citizens. They are in part of your kingdom. You should protect them.
树木，这些树木也是整个国家的臣民，所以应该受到你的保护。
Right. We see in the world there are many different people, different living entities, different things which protect and maintain us.
我们在这个世界可以看到有很多种其他的这些生物在维系着我们。
So these trees, they have to also be given protection by the kings and by the rulers.
所以这些树木都应该受到统治者和国王的保护。
Just like the parents, they are responsible to protect and maintain their children.
就像父母他应该保护他们的孩子。
The same way the king has to see that all the parents do their duty properly.
国王的职责同时也要监督所有的父母能够正确地履行这些父母们的职责。
And the king should make sure everybody who's a protector and maintainer should do his duty.
国王还负责监督每一个人既是保护者也是维系者。
Just like beggars, they should also be maintained by the householders.
就像乞丐也应该得到居士的维系。
But these beggars are not professional beggars.
但是这些乞丐不应该是那些职业的乞丐。
These beggars are people like the sannyasis and the brahmanas who have no means of income.
这些乞丐应该是指那些 sannyasi 或者说婆罗门 brahmana 他们没有收入。
So they come to householders and the householders will help them. They'll give some food or some cloth.
所以他们会去到一些居士的家庭里面，这些居士会给他们一些食物、一些衣服。
So the Supreme Lord Krishna is in the heart of everyone as the super soul. He's in the heart of all living entities.
至尊人格守神他以超灵的形式居住在所有生物体的心中。
Includes men and birds and animals and trees.
不仅包括人还包括所有的动物植物还有鸟儿等等。
So you should think of all these different bodies, they're just like a temple of Krishna.
我们应该认为所有不同的这些躯体只是 Krishna 的一座庙宇。
If you see them like that, then that will be very pleasing to Krishna.
如果你是一种这样的视觉、视域或理解的话，你会很取悦 Krishna.
You shouldn't get angry with them and kill them.
你不应该非常愤怒或者说杀掉他们。
So, everyone should see, remember, Krishna's in the heart of all living entities.
每一个人都应该看到 Krishna 在每一个生物体的心中。
We should see these different bodies just like a temple.
我们看到不同的这些躯体只是 Krishna 的一座庙宇。
So Soma, the moon god, he tells the Pratetas that because they had tried to satisfy the super soul, now they should not make him upset, they should not make him angry.They should please him.
Soma 在这里告诉 Pratetas, 他说你们曾经很努力地想取悦超灵，但是在现在你不要使超灵感到不满意。
Right. When they went to do their austerity, when they went into the bottom of the ocean, they did that to satisfy the super soul.
他们曾经想到他们曾经在水底做冥想做苦行的时候，他们其实就是要取悦超灵。
So now you should not make him angry.
但是现在你就不要让超灵又感到不满意。
So you have to subdue your anger.
你应该控制自己的愤怒。
Right? This anger, your anger has come suddenly.Just like something falls from the sky suddenly, so your anger suddenly came.
这个愤怒好像从天而降，突然就来了。
So you have to transcend this influence of the material nature.
你应该超越这种物质自然属性的影响。
Just like when we become angry, we forget our actual position, we forget who we are, we forget we're spiritual beings.
当我们愤怒的时候，我们会忘记我们的处境，我们会忘记我们是一个人类。
But if we remember our situation and if we use knowledge, then we can overcome the material nature.
但是如果我们能够通过知识去了解自己的处境，我们就能够超越这种愤怒。
We're always a servant of our lusty desires.
我们总是我们色欲的仆人。
And then we have anger and greed.
And
we have illusion and envy. But if we make some spiritual advancement, then we can control these things. And if we can control them, then we can transcend the material nature.
这些愤怒的话, 我们就能超越
To transcend the material nature, we have to engage in devotional service.
要超越物质自然属性, 我们得做奉献服务。
Right. So this is the purpose of our Krishna consciousness movement, to keep us always engaged in Krishna service.
这就是我们Krishna知觉运动的目的, 让我们总是处在对Krishna知觉的奉献服务之中。
So we should always be transcendental to anger and greed and lust and envy.
我们应该总是超越愤怒、贪婪、色欲、嫉妒等等。
Otherwise, we'll just be in the material nature, the modes of nature, passion and ignorance.
否则的话，我们就会成为
So Soma, the moon god, tells the pratetas, you don't need to burn these trees anymore.
Soma 告诉 pratetas, 你不要再燃烧这些树木。
Whatever trees are remaining, leave them, let them stay.
无论这些树木怎么样, 你就让它们保持它们的原样就行了。
And you should also be happy.
这样的话, 你也, 你也, 同时, 你也应该保持你的快乐。
So, here is a beautiful, very qualified girl named Marisha.
现在这里有一个非常品质优, 品质优秀的, 美丽的女孩, 叫做Marisha。
And she was raised by the trees, she was the daughter of the trees.
她们是树木的女儿, 是树木把她们供, 抚养。
So you can accept this beautiful girl as your wife.
你们可以把这个女孩作为接受这个女孩，然后娶她为妻。
So this way, Soma pacified the Prachetas and he gave them this beautiful girl to become their wife.
所以 Soma 就把这个女孩给了 Prachetas 作为他们的妻子。
This girl was actually born from An apsara named Pramlocha.
这个女孩实际上是来自于 Apsara 或 Pramlocha.
Yeah, Apsara. Apsara is like a demigod, you know.
Okay.
So, the Prachetas, they all took this woman as their wife. And she was a very beautiful woman, and they married her according to the religious system. So they all 10 men met and took her as their wife.
所有的这些 Prachetas 都接受了这个美丽的女孩，并接受她们为自己的妻子。就是这十个 Prachetas 都接受她为妻子，他们按照的宗教的这种伟大的这种传统接受她为妻子。
So in the womb of that girl, the Prachetas, they produced a son named Daksha.
通过这个女孩的子宫, Prachetas 得到一个儿子, 他叫Daksha.
And Daksha, he was able to bring many living entities into the world.
Daksha, 他让整个世界充满了生物体。
Now Daksha had been born before. He'd been born during the reign of Swayambhuva Manu.
Daksha 首先诞生在 Swayambhuva Manu的这个时期,
but he had offended Lord Shiva.
但是那个时候他冒犯了主Shiva.
And he was punished, his head was cut off, and then he was given the head of a goat in place of his own head.
他得到的惩罚就是他的头掉了，然后替换成一个羊头。
So he that was a, of course it was a very humiliating thing to have the head of a goat. So he gave up that body and he took birth again.
得到这个羊头其实是一个很屈辱的这个事情，他放弃了这个躯体，然后再一次投生。
So it's mentioned he was born in the sixth manvantara, right? We said there were, now we're in the seventh manvantara. So Daksha was born initially in the sixth manvantara, the Chakshusha manvantara.
我们说我们现在是处在第七个manvantara。 而 Daksha 他放弃了之后，他是在第六个 Manvantara 叫 Chakshusha Manvantara 的时候投生的。Yeah,
the first Manvantara was Svayambhuva Manu.
第一个 Manvantara 是 Svayambhuva Manu.
And then the sixth Manvantara is this Chakshusha Manvantara.
第六个 Manvantara 叫 Chakshusha Manvantara.
And we're now in the seventh, we're in the Vaivashvata Manvantara.
我们现在处在第七个Manvantara, 叫 Vaivashvata Manvantara.
So Daksha's body, previous body had been, it was destroyed.
Daksha先前的这个躯体已经毁灭了。But
it came again in this Chakshusha Manvantara.
他在第六个Manvantara Chakshusha Manvantara 的时候再一次又来了。And
he again became a Prajapati, and his job was to fill up the universe with living entities.
这一次他又成为 Prajapati, 成为所有生物，就是繁衍生物体。So
he was, you know, the word Daksha means one who is very expert.
Daksha的意思是指一个非常专业的人。
So he was very expert to produce children. He had millions of children to fill the three worlds.
他非常擅长于繁衍后代。他在三个世界繁衍了千百万的孩子。So
Sukadeva Goswami says, I want to tell you about how Prajapati Daksha had so much affection to his daughters.
Sukadeva Goswami 这里继续说到 Prajapati Daksha 他是如何受他自己女儿的影响。
He created, and through these daughters he was able to create many living entities.
通过他这个女儿，他创造了很多的生物体。
Different types of living entities through his mind and through his semen.
Prajapati 是通过他的精液和心意创造了很多的生物体。
So all the living entities that were born from Daksha's daughters.
Sorry?
All of the living entities, they were born from the daughters of Daksha.
所有的这些生物体都是来自于Daksha的女儿。
We don't hear that Daksha had any sons.
我们没有听到Daksha有儿子。
Actually, in other places we hear that he had sons, but Narada Muni made them all into devotees.
在之前我们听过Narada，就是Daksha他有很多的儿子，但是Narada Muni却把他们全部变成了奉献者。
Narada Muni preached to them and he told them, don't get married, don't go home, just stay a devotee and don't go back home. So this way Daksha's sons, every time he would send them away to get to do meditation and then come back to get married, before they came back, Narada Muni would preach to them and say, don't go home.
在先前，Daksha每一次就是生了很多的这些儿子之后， Narada Muni都在半途中告诉这些儿子们说，你们不要再回家了，你们就当奉献者。所以每一次这些
So Daksha thought, not very good, I don't need sons, I'll just make daughters instead of sons, I'll just have daughters.
所以Daksha就说我再不需要儿子了，我现在就生女儿就好了。
because the girls, they're not going to do like these boys.
这些女儿们可不像这些男孩子们。
So within the mind of Daksha, he first of all created the demigods and the demons and the human beings.
通过 Daksha 的心意，他创造出各种各样的半神人、恶魔，还有各种各样的人类。
And he created birds and beasts and fit different creatures of the sea, aquatics.
他创造了飞禽走兽，还有水里面的各种各样的生物体。
But Daksha saw that he was not generating all kinds of living entities. He was not satisfied.
但是 Daksha 看到自己没有适当的繁衍出所有的这些生物体时，他并不感到满意。
So he went to a range of mountains called the Vindhya Mountains, and he began to do great austerity there.
于是他就去到温迪亚这个山附近，他在那里做很严酷的苦行。
So near that mountain, there was a holy place.
在那个山附近有一个圣地
，Agamarsana，
叫 Agamarsana。
So Prajapati did rituals there, and he satisfied the Supreme Lord.
Daksha 在那里做了很多的伟大的仪式，取悦了至尊主。
So Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit, I will explain to you the prayers which were offered to the Supreme Lord by Daksha.
Sukadeva Goswami 跟 Maharaj Parikshit 说，我现在将给你全面的解释这个由 Daksha 供奉给至尊主的祷文。
These prayers are called the Hamsa Guya prayers.
这个祷文叫做 Hamsa Guya 祷文。
And I will tell you how Krishna was pleased with him for these prayers.
我也会向你解释至尊主到底是如何被这些祷文所感到满意的。
So these prayers, they're not composed, it wasn't that Daksha composed them, they were already there in the Vedic scriptures.
事实上，这个祷文还不是 Daksha 写的，这些祷文已经存在于伟大文献之中。
So the prayers begin describing that the Supreme Lord is transcendental to the illusory energy.
这个祷文开始是说，至尊人格守神超越物质能量。
And the Lord possesses potency for great knowledge.
至尊主拥有无穷无尽的知识能力。
And he is the controller of all the living entities.
他是所有生物体的控制者。
And he is the controller of the illusory energy also.
而且他还控制着虚幻的能量。
But conditioned souls in material life, they cannot see him.
这些受条件限制的生物体无法看见他。
He is above the powers of their vision.
他超越于这些人的视域。
So he is not caused by any other cause. He is the original cause.
他不是其他原因所造成的，他是原始的那一位原因。
So in this way,Prajapati Daksha describes the position of the Supreme Lord.
就这样 ，Prajapati Daksha 向解释了、描述了至尊主。
We cannot see him by material vision.
我们无法通过物质的视觉看到他。
We cannot understand how the Lord exists in his own abode.
我们也无法理解至尊主在他。自己的居所里。
Even if a materialistic person could count all the atoms of the universe, still they could not understand the Supreme Lord.
即便一个物质主义者，他能够计算出整个宇宙之内的所有的原子的数目， 他也无法了解至尊主。
We may try to understand him for many billions of years, but we will never be able to understand him.
我们甚至想去通过推敲他，通过上百亿年的时间去了解他，但是仍然可能理解不了他。
You may travel at the speed of the mind or the wind, but still you will never be able to understand the Lord.
我们或许能够用心意或者风的速度去旅行，但是我们仍然无法理解主。
Because the Lord's existence is inconceivable, beyond the power of our mind and senses.
因为主是不可思议的，他超越心意和感官。
So we may say, then how can we understand him?
但是我们或许又会提出疑问，那我们如何了解主呢？
We have to understand him in his own, by his own spiritual potency.
那么我们就得通过他自身的能量去理解主。
Whether we understand him or not, he is in his own spiritual potency.
无论我们是否能够了解他，他都处在自己的灵性的能量之中。
Okay, we will stop here.
Okay.
Are there any questions?
Yes. First question from Shamasaki David Dasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤德和所有的奉献者，我的问题是 Chatriya 到森林中练厮杀的本领，猎杀动物吃鹿肉，这样的 Chatriya 不是主的奉献者是吗？攀到我们是 Chatriya 也是主伟大的奉献者，他们在森林里待了那么多年，但是他们不吃任何动物的肉，所以都是 Chatriya 却有着天壤之别是吗？面对新人会有这样的问题，感恩咕噜的回答。Hare Krishna, basis to Gurudev and the devotees. My question is, when the Chatriya go to the forest, they learning the kill ability, learn how to kill, and kill the animals, eating the deer meat. So this kind of Chatriya is the Lord devotee?
Yes.
是的，这样的 Chatriya 也是主的奉献者。
They will hunt wild animals.
他们会杀这些动物的。
It's customary that they, because they are Kshatriyas and they have to be able to defend against the enemy, against the attacks of demons. So they have to be able to fight and they have to be able to kill. So they have to practice. They practice by hunting animals.
因为这是他们的能力，他们做一个Kshatriya，他必须要有防御的能力，他能够抵御敌人，也能够杀敌人，所以这是他们的能力，他们也会到森林里面去杀一些动物。So when they eat the deer meat, are they the Lord devotee? This is the first question.
Yes, they're still devotees.
他们仍是奉献者。
But you can say they're not pure devotees.
他们是奉献者，但不是纯粹的奉献者。
Just like in the Krishna book, it's described about there was one great Kshatriya king. What's his name again? There was one Kshatriya king. He was fighting for the demigods against the demons, and the demigods were very pleased with him. So they gave him a benediction. Whatever he wanted, he could ask for.
在 Krishna Book 里面描述到这样一个插曲啊，他为半世人们去攻打一个恶魔，最后这个半世人们对这个插曲啊感觉到非常的满意，所以给予了他一个祝福，说无论你想要什么都会得到。
So he said, "Give me a benediction that I can take rest." He said, "I'm very tired. I've been fighting for a long time, and I want to have a rest. Nobody should disturb me."
他说，那就给我一个祝福，让我能够休息，因为我打了很长时间的仗，我非常疲惫，我想要休息，不要让别人来打扰我。
So the demigods blessed him that he could sleep. He said, "If anybody wakes you up, when you open your eyes, you'll burn them to ashes."
所以半神们给了他一个祝福，你现在可以睡觉了，你也可以休息，无论有谁他去打扰你的时候，当你一睁开眼睛的时候，你的这个眼光的这个喷出的这个火就会把对方烧成灰烬。
So he went and he took rest. He went in a cave and he took his rest there, and he was sleeping there in a cave.
所以他就到一个山洞里面就去休息去了。
So it happened that Lord Krishna was being attacked by a demon called Kalayavana.
这个时候 Krishna 有一天呢 Krishna 被 Kalayavana 被他攻击被他追赶。
And Lord Krishna ran up a mountain to get away from Kalayavana.
Krishna 就跑到一个山顶上想躲开 Kalayavana.
And Kalayavana was chasing Krishna. He wanted to fight Krishna. So he came after Krishna.
Kalayavana 就一直追赶着 Krishna, 想打败他。
So Krishna went into the cave. He went into this cave in the mountain.And Kalayavana followed him.
Krishna 于是就跑到这个山洞里面 ，Kalayavana 也追赶着他。
And Kalayavana went in the cave and he saw this person laying on the ground, and he thought that was Krishna, so he kicked him.
当这个 Kalayavana 去到这个山洞的时候，他发现山洞有一个人躺在那儿，他认为那个躺着的人就是 Krishna。于是用脚踢了他一下。
But actually, it wasn't Krishna. It was this great Kshatriya king who had been given a benediction that if anybody woke him up, they would be burned to ashes.
事实上，那个躺着的人不是 Krishna， 是一个伟大的 Kshatriya， 而就是先前我们所说的被这个半世人所赐福的这个 Kshatriya。任何人如果唤醒了他的话，他都能够睁开眼，把他燃烧成灰烬。
So when he opened his eyes, Kalayavana burned to ashes.
当他一睁开眼睛的时候 ，Kalayavana 就燃烧成了灰烬。
So then Lord Krishna came, and he met this Kshatriya king, and they spoke to each other.
所以 Krishna 来了，他就跟这个 Kshatriya 交，也看到 Kshatriya 想跟他谈了起来。
And it was described how the Kshatriya king, he saw that Kali Yuga had begun because all the trees had become small compared to when he was fighting before. He'd been fighting a long time in the heavenly planets for the demigods. And when he came back here, time had progressed and the trees had become much smaller than they used to be. Because he could understand Kali Yuga is going to begin soon.
他就说到，因为他给半神人做这个事情打了很长时间的这个仗，当他从那里下来的时候，他来到这个地上，发现这里的树木非常的渺小，比以前要小多了，他就能够觉察到这个卡利年代可能就要到来了。
So, after offering obeisances to Lord Krishna and offering prayers to Lord Krishna, then he left.To perform austerity.
当他给 Krishna 做完顶拜，然后献上祷文之后，他就离开了，然后做
And it was
做自己从事自己的苦行去了又。
And it's mentioned there that he wouldn't be able to go back to Godhead in this lifetime. He'd have to take birth again, because he killed many animals.
在那里这样描述到，他不可能在那在这一生在他那一生就能够直接回归守神，他必须再一次投生，因为他这一生杀了很多的动物。
So Kshatriyas, they, when they do this animal killing, of course they get some karma for that. It stops them from going back to Godhead.
这个 Kshatriya, 由于杀了很多的动物，他所以从事了很多的这些积累了很多的这业报，在这一生 不可能直接回归。
But they're still devotees.
但是仍然他是一个奉献者。Yes. Second, she asked, Pandavas are Kshatriya and the great devotees when they are in the forest, but they didn't eat any meat. So, even the Kshatriyas, the different Kshatriya, they have the different qualities.
Yes.
Yes.
Some Kshatriyas eat meat and some don't.
是的，有一些叉翅啊是吃肉的，有一些叉翅啊是不吃肉的。
Just like Ranti Dev, it's mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam about Ranti Dev that in his whole life he never ate meat.
就像在这个圣典波迦瓦坛里面提到 Ranti Deva Maharaj, 他在他的一生之中都没有吃过肉。
Okay.
Next question from Tejas Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜灵性导师和奉献者。主 Chaitanya 说过，见到每一个人都应该向他们传播圣名。现实中在推广圣名时，特别是向一些素食者传播时，他们许多都是佛教徒，能接受的有，但是不多。许多可能以后不再深入合作，他们认为我们是印度教徒，与佛教不同。我的问题是应该坚持传播，还是有时候先忍一忍，先不让他们知道我们的信仰。 Hare Krishna, obeisance to you. The Lord Chaitanya said, when we meet everyone, we should preach them the holy name. So in our condition, when we preach the holy name, especially to some vegetarian, they are Buddhism.Some of them they accept, but not many. And some of them will not cooperate with us anymore, because they think us is they recognize us is as Hinduism. We are not, and we are different from the Buddhism. So my question is, we should insist the preaching, or we should tolerate?And we not, first, we not let them know our Krishna consciousness.
Yes, I think you're running a restaurant, you're selling food, your business is more to distribute prasadam, distribute food. You don't have to worry so much about trying to preach to everybody who comes there.
是的，你现在开了一个素食馆，你的工作，你的职责是把这个普沙等通过这个地方派发出去，你不用太多的担心，像太多的着急把这个圣名给予他们。
Let them come and eat. Let them get attached to eating the food there.
就让他们在那里吃，就让他们能够对。你那里吃的东西感到依附，就是很依附吃，很喜欢吃你那里的食物。
Yeah, your real business is to distribute, to sell the food and to get customers to come and eat the food.
你真正的工作是让他们是让这个顾客去吃你的食物。
And if they come and ask you, if they inquire about your beliefs, then okay, you can tell them, but.You don't have to go to just to preach to them if they don't ask.
如果他们向你问起，询问你， 向你提问的话，你可以告诉他们，否则的话，没有必要一定告诉他们你的信仰。
If they like the food, they'll come. If they like the food, they'll come and eat. They come to eat. They don't come to hear you preach.
如果他喜欢你的食物的话，他会来吃。如果他来吃的话，他们不是想来聆听的。
And you can tell them also you're not Hindu.
你也可以告诉他们你不是印度教徒。
You're teaching, you're just preaching the absolute truth.
你只是在传播绝对真理。
If they are truthful, then they have to accept.
如果他们是真实，如果他们追求真理的话，如果他们是诚实的话，他们会接受的。Next question from Bhakta left.
Yes.
Hare Krishna, okay. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和奉献者 Daksha。Daksha 作为奉献者，为了完成他的父亲职责而生儿子，但是那Narada Muni 却让他的儿子们都变成了纯粹奉献者，导致无法完成他的使命，甚至因此他诅咒的Narada Muni。如何理解这种表面上的矛盾 ？Hare Krishna bases to Guru and the devotees. Daksha as a devotee and he do his duty. So he have a lot of sum, but Narada Muni, but however, Narada Muni make all the sons to become a pure devotees. That make Daksha cannot accomplish his duty. And also, the Narada Muni was cursed by the Daksha. So how to understand this contradiction?
Well, Daksha's curse of Narada Muni was also beneficial to Narada Muni. It was not a problem for Narada Muni.
Daksha 给 Narada Muni 的这种诅咒对 Narada Muni 来说并不是一种坏处，而对 Narada Muni 来说甚至是一个好的事情。
Daksha cursed Narada Muni that he would not be able to stay one place for any long time. So that was an advantage for Narada Muni.
Daksha 诅咒 Narada Muni 不能够在一个地方待很长的时间，这对 Narada Muni 来说是一个。
Hare Bo?
Hare Krishna, sorry.My mic is 这对 Narada 就是说 Daksha 诅咒 Narada Muni， 但是这个诅咒对于 Narada Muni 来说是一个益处。
Yeah, the Narada Muni won't get attached. He won't be able to stay one place. That's good for him, because he's a brahmachari. Doesn't want to get entangled. Stay one place.
因为 Narada Muni 是一个 brahmachari， 他。如果这样的诅咒对于他来说非常的好，他这样就不会太依附于一个地方了。
So everybody benefited. The sons of Daksha benefited.
而且每一个人都受到了益处，包括 Daksha 的儿子们也受到了益处。
Daksha also benefits. His sons all become great devotees. He doesn't know it. He doesn't appreciate it, but he benefits.
Daksha 的儿子都成为了纯粹的奉献者，虽然 Daksha 并不欣赏一点，但是 Daksha 为此也会受益。
And Narada Muni benefits also.
Narada Muni 也受到了，也得到了益处。
Made some devotees.
他转变了一些奉献者。
And he's got the opportunity to keep moving, to keep traveling.
而且他得到了一个机会，能够让他一直旅行。
Is it clear? Back to left. You can understand, man.
Back to left. 您能够理解一点吗？ Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from CCM. 顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译，怎样了解主？只有主亲自揭示他自己。上面的问题里也提到，主柴坦尼亚让我们见到每一个人都传播圣名，这可以理解为主在通过他的奉献者揭示本身吗？Obeisance to Guru, how to understand the Lord? Because the Lord said the only way is the Lord revealed himself. And in the previous question also mentioned about the Lord Chaitanya said, when we meet everyone, we should preach them the holy name. So can we understand that the Lord revealed himself by his devotee?
Yes.Yes, Krishna's devotees, they're one and different. That's the philosophy, achintya bheda bheda tattva, one and different. The devotees also represent Krishna.
Achintya bheda bheda tattva, 这个是我们的这个哲学，就是记忆记忆。奉献者代表着 Krishna, 但是奉献者也不同于 Krishna.
So devotees are always speaking the glories of Krishna.
So the 奉献者总是讲述着主的 Krishna 的荣耀。
So they give the greatest benefit to all the conditioned souls.
这是给予所有受条件限制灵魂最大的益处。
But of course I was just mentioning, like Tejas was saying about his, you know, they have a restaurant and people come there. And so if you go and preach to them all the time and you tell them to chant the holy name, then they may not come anymore. They get tired of somebody coming. So you have to be conscious about how we preach and who we preach to.
就像我们前面所提到的 Tejas Prabhu 那个问题，因为他经营着一个素食的餐厅，所以呢，很多人去他那里吃饭。如果你总是想要着向他们传播圣名的话，他们有可能就不来了。所以你得注意到这一点，我们应该如何向他去传播，应该小心这一点，应该想一想办法如何去传播。
Yeah, there are many living entities everywhere, so we have to also, you know, we have to.Move around and give the mercy to everyone.
在这个世界有在每一个地方都有不同的生物体，我们可以移动移动，到处走一走，看一看，把这个圣名给予每一个人。
Yeah, certain people, some people, they won't like to hear, they won't like it.
当然，有一些人。也不会喜欢您，有一些人他是不喜欢您听的。
They've got their own ideas and their own faith, so we have to be sensitive to what people are like, what the people like, what they don't like.
有一些人他喜欢，有一些人他却有自己的想法、自己的信仰和自己的喜欢和不喜欢，所以我们应该敏感一些。我们敏感一些，到底谁喜欢我们的东西，到底谁不喜欢。
So if you're having a restaurant and every time people come there, you teach them, you talk to them about chanting Hare Krishna, they'll stop coming because they think this guy is always trying to tell me to chant Hare Krishna. So they'll get tired, they won't come.
如果你总是像这个来你这里的个人向这些客人告诉他们 Hare Krishna, 唱诵 Hare Krishna,或许他们就不再来了。他说他会觉得你们这些人总是让我唱 Hare Krishna, 我不太想来。
So we have to let them come and eat and get the mercy of Krishna through the food, through the prasadam.
因此我们就让他们来吃我们的这个 prasadam, 这个 prasadam 也是 Krishna 的仁慈。
There may be some other people, some rare person who wants to know more about Krishna. So then you can give them special attention.
有其他一些人 或许他们更多的想了解 Krishna， 这样你就给他们多一些注意力。
Okay.
Next question from Sati Madaji. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者。圣典博加瓦坛 6.4.9 世界说，鹿和山羊等四条腿的动物和谷物是专门为人类准备的食物。那么这是不是会被吃肉的人推举出作为吃肉是被经典所允许的这种证据？Obeisance to Guru Maharaj and devotees. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, today we learned it mentioned about the deer and the goats, and the four-legged animals and the grains are the food prepared for the human beings. So this sentence can be used by the people who want to eat meat as their evidence to say that eat meat, it can be allowed by the sastras.
Yes. We know there's always a class of people who will eat meat.
是的，总是有那么一些人他是想要吃肉的。
But there's certain animals which are their prescribed meat.
但是有确定有一些确定的这些动物是才被允许给他们吃的。
We don't allow people to eat cows. That's the point.
我们不让人们去吃牛，这是重点。
Under any condition, you cannot eat cow.
在任何的情况下，我们都不能吃母牛。
They want to eat the meat?Okay, go hunt the animal, and then you can eat goat or wild pig or deer.
如果他们想吃肉，那就让他们去，去打猎，去吃一头野猪、鹿、山羊。
In the scriptures, there's also provision to eat goat. You take the goat before the goddess Kali on a full moon night. Full moon night means once in a month.
在这个经典也有讲吃山羊的这个例子，就是说在月圆的那一天，一个人想吃山羊的话，他得到卡利女神的面前。
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's not full moon night. Maybe it's dark moon night. On the dark moon night.
或许不是月圆之夜，是一个月黑之夜。
It's once in a month.You can take the animal like a goat before the goddess Kali, and you tell it, I'm killing you, in the future you can kill me.
反正不管是怎样，就是说一个月只有一天，而且他在吃之前，他得对那个山羊讲，在这一生我吃了你，之后你也可以吃我。
Just like we heard, Narada Muni went to the father of the Prajetas.And he was killing many animals in Vedic sacrifices.
就像我们今天也讲到的，南尔德穆里去到 Pacheta 的父亲面前，他说：“你做了很多的动物祭祀，杀了很多的动物。”
So Narada Muni told him, he said, "These animals are all waiting for you." He said, "They're going to kill you and get you."
他说：“你杀了这么多动物，这些动物也在等着要杀你，他们也准备要杀了你。”
So the law of karma is there. You're going to eat meat, you're going to kill animals, the future you'll be killed.
这个业报的法则是存在的。你现在杀动物，你将来也会被动物所伤。
Yeah, you can eat. There's a class of people. These people, the Prabhupada writes there, he says, Sudras, Kshatriyas, these people, they will eat meat.
确实是有一些阶层的人，他们想吃肉的。这样他圣帕帕德在这个里面讲到的，有一些叉锤啊，有一些书爪，他们就是想要吃肉。
But they get karma for that.
但是他们也会得到业报。
Okay.
Last question also from Sati Madhuji. 有修佛的新朋友问我，问我们能不能带着这个肉身达到完美，我们应该如何回答？Buddhism new friend ask us whether can we use this take this body become get the perfection. How can we reply this question?
Can we use this body to get perfection?
Yes.
Yes, of course. We have to use this body to get perfection.
是的，当然，我们应该用这个肉身得到完美。
We have to understand this body belongs to Krishna.
我们得理解到这个躯体是属于 Krishna.
It's given to us by Krishna to be used in his service.
Krishna 给予我们这个是用于他的服务之中。
So, yeah, why we shouldn't get perfection with this body? It depends on us how we use this body.
我们为什么不用这个躯体的呢？而其实所有的一切是取决于我们怎么样用这个躯体。
You have to know how to get perfection. You use this body to hear, use the body to chant. This is important. If you use your body like this, then certainly you'll get perfection.
我们运用这个躯体去聆听、去唱诵，这是我们运用这个躯体的方法和途径。通过这样，我们毫无疑问能够得到完美。
We use our senses. We use the senses not for our sense gratification, but we use them in devotional service.
我们运用我们的感官，不是为我们的感官快乐，而是运用我们的感官去从事奉献服务。
We have to make the best use of the bad bargain. Material body is like a bad bargain.
我们应该最大化的利用我们的这个躯体作为我们的这个目标。
You go shopping sometimes, you buy something, you think you're getting a bargain, but you find out it's really a bad bargain. It's not a good bargain.
我们去超市，我们想买一些东西，我们认为我们达成了我们的目标，但是其实我们并没有达到我们想要的。
I remember I was with one devotee, and he happened to see a bag which he liked, and it was a famous name, it was a famous brand name, and he thought, oh, it's a very good bag.And he saw the brand name, he thought it was very, and he asked the shop, how much was it? He thought, oh, very cheap. So he bought it.
我有一个朋友，他曾经非常喜欢一个品牌的这个包，然后呢，他非常钟爱这个包，然后他去一个超市去问这个包，说这个多少钱，别人说这个告诉他之后，他说：“哦，这么便宜啊。”
So he bought it and brought it home, and 2 days later or next day, and the whole thing just fell apart. It was completely useless.
然后两天之后，这个包就完全好像作废了一样，就完全没有用处了，坏了。
So he thought he was getting a bargain, but it was a bad bargain.
所以他认为他是实现了他的目标，实际上那是一个不好的目标，或者说是一个并不怎么样的。
So human body is like that.
人体生命也是这样。
It's a bad bargain.
一个不好的目。
You know, we think we're, oh, very nice, have a nice body, nice healthy body, strong body.And then you start to get sick, you get disease, you get problems.
我们认为我们自己，哦，这是一个非常好的躯体，太美妙了。 但是呢，你经常就得病了。
And we find so many difficulties with the material world.
而且我们在这个物质世界也会发现太多太多的困难了。
So that's the nature of the material world.
这就是这个物质自然的本性。
We came here to enjoy, but it's so difficult to enjoy.
我们是想，我们原本打算的来到这个物质世界是享受的，但是发现这里太难以享受了。
Human life is not meant for trying to enjoy the body.
人体生命并不是为了享受而准备的。
But if we use this body, the mind and senses, in the service of Krishna, then we can be happy.
但如果我们运用我们的感官、意义和我们的躯体去服务 Krishna 的话，我们可以变得快乐。
This is something which every devotee experiences by doing devotional service.
这是一些奉献者们所都经历过的，通过奉献服务所感受到的。
So Krishna consciousness is a process. You follow the rules and regulations.
所以 Krishna 知觉是一个程序，我们去遵循这个规则和程序。
And you can come to understand how Krishna consciousness is so satisfying, so happy, so natural.
这样我们就慢慢的理解它是多么的令人满足，而且多么的自然。
And it's so easy, it's not difficult.
而且它非常的简单，并不困难。
You don't have to do any great austerity.
你不需要从事那么严苛的苦行。
You just simply have to chant Hare Krishna and dance and eat prasadam.
你只需要唱诵 Hare Krishna, 跳舞然后吃 prasadam.
Worship Krishna, bow down to Krishna.
崇拜 Krishna, 向 Krishna 顶拜。
We have beautiful songs about Krishna.
我们还有给 Krishna 的美丽的优美的歌曲
singing all the names of Krishna
唱诵 Krishna 所有的名字
so this just it's so easy to become Krishna conscious
实际上变成 Krishna 知觉是非常容易的
but we're so stubborn we don't want to do it
但是我们非常的愚蠢，我们并不想做。
If you study Buddhism, there's so many things you have to do, so much control the senses, so many rules and regulations.
你去再看一看这个佛教徒他们的规矩，他们有很多的事情要做，也有很多的规范原则。
We only have four rules.
我们只有四个基本规范原则。
They have so many rules in Buddhism, and hardly they can follow any of them.
他们有那么多的规范原则，而且你几乎无法遵循这些规范原则。
OK, 还有问题吗
？OK.
Hi Krishna, good day.
Sati.
对。他们通过苦行得到了一些神秘的力量和视域，所以他们看到一些东西，所以他们认为我们这个很浅显。
他们认为什么？
就是我们这个修习就是很简单嘛，然后他们认为就很浅，因为没有像他们看到那些实际的修行的那个感受。
Because they do some austerities, they think they get some mystical power, and they see us with their power, they think us very low, not very high.
Yeah, that's right. They have a very bodily conception. They're looking at everything with their material eyes.
是的，他们有他们的这种 他们有太强的躯体化的概念，而且他们用他们的眼睛在看。
So it's very difficult to bring Buddhists into Krishna consciousness because they have all of these misconceptions.
他们有，所以把这个佛教徒转变成一个奉献者是很难的。他们有很多的错误的概念。
They've been conditioned to thinking what is advance, what is advancement. They're thinking austerity is great advancement.
因为他们已经有这种很固有的概念，到底什么是非常精进的人？他们认为苦行就是一个很精进的象征。
So this is discussed in the sixth canto Srimad Bhagavatam. It explains that simply by doing austerities, you don't take away your material desires. You still have deep-rooted material desires.
我们在圣典波迦瓦坛里面也了解到了，仅仅只是通过苦行，并不能拿走你的物质欲望。你的物质欲望的这个根还在你的内心。
They may get some mystic powers.But you, just like we were just telling, the Prachetas, they became angry so easily. They saw the trees, they became so angry.
他们得到一些物质的玄秘的力量，做了一些苦行。但是你会发现这些，做了同样做了苦行的这些 Prachetas, 他们很容易就愤怒起来。他们把所有的这些树木烧成了灰烬。
So devotee controls his anger.Very tolerant, peaceful. That is the wealth of the devotee. The Buddhists, they don't have that kind of wealth.
但是奉献者们，他们是宽容，他们是容忍的，他们不会有这种愤怒。这就是奉献者的财富。但是这些佛教徒不会有这样的，不会有这样的富裕，不会有这样的品质。
The devotee's material desires are all removed at the root. The roots are pulled out.
奉献者的物质欲望的根被移除了。
So it's Krishna consciousness which is the supreme power, not these austerities, not the, what these people are thinking, spiritual advancement.
Krishna 知觉才是真正的玄秘的力量，而不是这些苦行，或者说这些物质主义者所拥有带来的这种力量。
They do not understand what spirit means. They do not understand that there's a spiritual energy which is eternal. They are thinking everything is ultimately nothing.
他们甚至不知道什么叫做灵性，他们不知道。灵性的这种永恒，他们认为所有的一切是空虚空的。
Anyway, it's not a good idea to debate philosophy with them because you just simply end up arguing.
当然，与他们进行这种辩论是不太好的一个观点。你仅仅只是停止和他们争吵即可。
You want to attract them to the chanting of Hare Krishna and Krishna Prasada.
你就让他们受 Krishna 的 prasadam 以及唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，让他们被这两个所吸引就好了。
If you just talk to them philosophy, you'll just argue, they'll debate, that nobody will get any, that it won't be beneficial. Don't waste your time.
如果你只是和他们进行这种来回的这种争论和辩论的话。对任何人来说都没有什么益处，这只是在浪费时间而已。
If they want to know our philosophy, you can say we have books. You can take one of the books. Read.
如果他们想了解我们的哲学，你就跟他说这就是我们的书，你给他们一本书就好了。
But just chant Hare Krishna and give them prasada.
只是唱，你对于他们而言，你就唱诵 Hare Krishna, 吃 prasada 就好了。
That's the only hope.The best hope for them to make advancement.
这是对于他们最好的帮助，他们最好的能够让他们得到进步的方法。
好的，好的，对，知道了，谢谢。我们还有最后一个问题，刘传华，马太吉。
OK， 还是OK， 顶拜 Guruji 奉献者们，平生吃肉的家人死亡。 我们给做唱诵圣名的祭司也是要祭司他也要承担业报吗？还是借着主的仁慈不受业报呢？不被不他所吃的动物下一世吃，还是平生吃肉的家人死亡，我们给做唱诵圣名的祭司他也要承担业报吗？哦、oh, ，OK， he asked, obeisance to guru, our families, but when they eat meat, at when after they death, and we do some kirtan, haninam, yagya, so after we do this sankirtan yagya, be during his death, as are this family member, he will also take the karma?
What karma? What karma?
Because this family member eat meat.
Well, when they eat meat, they get karma, yeah?
Yeah, but when he is going to die, and we do some sankirtan, this sankirtan can remove his karma or not?
Well, it depends on him, how much he hears and what kind of faith he has.
这个要取决于这个家人，你所描述的这个家人朋友，他自己，他到底对我们聆听的这个圣名有多大程度的信心。
There is quality in chanting, and similarly there is quality in hearing.
我们对唱诵有品质的要求，同时对聆听的这个品质也是有要求的。
So, hearing the holy name is certainly beneficial for everyone. To hear the holy name will benefit everyone. Haribo? Subhuti? Sati, 你在吗？
是的 ，Gurudev 我在。
啊，
我们听不到。
Do you Subhuti有问题啊？
是的，是他那里。那他那里
网络的问题。OK， 这个是最后一个问题，我可以自己讲中文了。如果是不的，
好的，谢谢古天。
嗯，所以我们说，听到奉献者唱 Hare Krishna， 净化帮助所有的生物体，他们都得到好处，他们听到。奉献者唱 Hare Krishna， 肯定他们有好处。可是我们不能说所有他们的罪恶都消掉，需要看他们听怎么样。如果他们好气的听到，他们不是冒犯的。有的人听啊，我不喜欢这个。为什么他们唱的？有的人不接受，所以他们的好处不大。可是如果他们听到 Hare Krishna， 觉得这个声音很好，他们听到 Krishna 的名字，他们唱 Krishna， 那说 Krishna 在他们的心意中肯定有好处，可以消掉他们的罪恶。所以好像阿扎米拉他讲他的儿子的名字 Narayana， 以后 Yellow Wong 的仆人走了， and Vishnu Dutta 的仆人他们也走了，那个时候阿扎米拉知道他有第二次机会，所以那个时候他离开家，他到 Hardware 那边，到圣地，在恒河岸边，他住在一个 Vishnu 的庙，在那边准备离开身体，过一会儿他也放弃他的身体，回归灵性世界。所以唱诵圣名，听到圣名有好处，有好处。可是
我 Hare Krishna，
哦，你会来。所以 hearing the Hare Krishna mantra is beneficial to everyone。
能听 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗对于每个人来说都是有益处的。
That's why we go for Sankirtan. We go in the streets and chant everywhere.
这就是我们做 Sankirtan 的目的，我们在每一个地方都去做齐颂圣名的这个运动。
Let people hear the holy name.
让所有的人都去聆听。
And if somebody at the point of death is hearing the holy name, it's very beneficial for him.
在临死之前能够聆听到圣名，也是对于他来说非常有益处的。
Will certainly help them to get a better destination in their next life.
很确定的能够帮助到他在下一世有一个更好的目的地。
They'll have the opportunity.To have association with devotees and to continue devotional service.
他会能够获得一个机会和奉献者联谊，能够从事奉献服务。
Yeah. Dear Bhupen, Nagavanti.
No, Dear Bhupen.
Really?
对，萨提玛吉，这个还回答吗？还有一个，
让他们两个再进。这样，那个今天因为咕噜他今天讲的课太多了，然后留在星期二再问吧，好吧？刚才说了是最后一个问题。
没问题，我还有十分钟。
OK。OK, next question from Radha Priya Mataji. 顶拜故唱诵圣名的奉献者对 Krishna 的信心和纯粹奉爱的程度会对聆听的人有不同的影响吗？还是圣名就是圣名，谁的唱诵效果都是一样？ A basis to Guru, people who chant the holy name, different people chant the holy name, they have the same effect to the people who are listening the holy name, or the holy name is just a holy name. Everyone listen the different people who chant the holy name is the same.
No, there's different qualities in the holy name depending on the people chanting.
不同的人唱诵的这个品质会有不同的这个影响，就是对聆听的这个人。
Right, the quality, the pure devotees chanting will be different from non-devotees chanting.
一个纯粹奉献者的唱诵是对与一个非奉献者的唱诵，这两者的这个圣名的品质是不一样的。
The Mayavadis sometimes they also chant the holy name.
那些 Mayavadi 虚无主义者，他们也唱诵圣名。
Of course, it's not really the holy name, but they're chanting Hare Krishna. They're chanting Hare Krishna, but they're chanting with offense, so it's not really the holy name.
他们虽然也是唱的 Hare Krishna, 但是他们唱诵之中带着冒犯。
Because they don't accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
因为他们并不接受 Krishna 是作为至尊人格首身。
So different people will have different effects in chanting the holy name.
所以不同的人的唱诵影响着这个圣名。
Sometimes people will chant the holy name professionally. They will do it just to make a show, just for entertainment.
有一些人他做这个唱诵只是做一场秀，只是为了娱乐大众而已。
And some people are chanting the holy name with pure love and devotion.
但是有一些人他唱诵的这个圣名，他是对 Krishna 有纯粹的爱。
Sometimes we will hear the devotees say, when we do kirtan, they will say, chant from the heart, chant from the heart.
有些时候我们听到一些奉献者他在领唱 Kirtan 的时候，他会说发自内心的去唱诵。
OK is it clear Radha Priya?
Radha Priya Mataji 您清楚吗？感谢姑姑，他说
OK
清楚了。 OK Tejas 问 Hare Krishna 顶拜离心导师和奉献者，6月27号明天周日，明天是 Tamna Krishna Goswami 75诞辰日，能分享一下您和他的逍遥时光吗？
Well that's a big question.
这是一个大的问题啊。
Anyway, I wrote an offering. Rajendra and I, we both wrote offerings to God. There was to be an e-book published for this occasion. And somebody wrote to me and asked me to write an offering. I wrote, and I asked Rajendra to write, and he also wrote, and we both submitted our offerings.
有人会做一个电子书，然后他也邀请了我和Rajendra， 就是说我们都会把我们的这个给 Tamna Krishna Goswami 写的这个祈祷文，写的供奉的这个祷文，都在这个文件里面都有。
Anyway, he was a very dear devotee of Srila Prabhupada, and he rendered very great service to Srila Prabhupada's mission.
不管怎样，他是 Tamna Krishna Goswami 是 Krishna 是圣帕帕的一个非常亲爱的奉献者。
And I feel very fortunate that I was able to have to be in his association and to know him for so many years.
我非常幸运和他有一段时间，然后为他服务了一段时间，跟他相处了很多年。
I was with him for maybe more than 20 years.
我和他大概在一起有20年的时间。
Of course, he was not always where I was, but I was working under him.
当然，我不总是和他在一起，我是在他的指导下工作的。
I came first. I was with him in Hong Kong, and then Philippines, and then China.
我曾去过，我去的是香港、菲律宾，然后再到中国。
So he was a great inspiration to all the devotees.
他对于所有的奉献者来说是一个很大的鼓舞。
He was a very advanced devotee. He had great love for Prabhupada.
他也是一个很精进的奉献者，他对圣帕帕德有很大的爱。
He rendered a lot of personal service to Prabhupada.
他也为圣帕帕德做过很多亲身的服务。
And he always reminded us about Prabhupada.
他也让我们总想起着帕帕，总想着圣帕帕。
He would often say.Whenever there was some problem, whenever there was something to be decided, he would say, I wonder what Prabhupada would do in this situation.
他总是说，当我们有一些困难，有一些需要什么东西，需要做一些决断的时候，他总是会说，我会想一想 Prabhupada 在这个时候会怎么样去做决定。
So we have an opportunity to remember him more tomorrow.
我们明天都会有一个机会去记忆他，纪念他。
So I'm sure Krishna Baladev Prabhu, when he gives class, usually tomorrow morning, he will speak about Tamal Krishna Maharaj.
明天 Krishna Baladev Prabhu 他也会讲这个 Tamna Krishna Goswami， 我相信。
Tomorrow Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Uh-huh.
明天那个 Tamala Krishna Goswami 的门徒们会在网上做一个庆典的节目，Chandrasekhar Prabhu 还有 Radhakrishna Prabhu 还有一些年长的门徒，我们在网在 Zoom 上会做这个节目。
几点？
十点钟，九点四十五。
九点四十五，早上。
对对。
到几点？
到十二点半。
Chandrasekhar Prabhu, 还有谁？
Radhakrishna Prabhu, 还有他，就都是门徒吧，都是门徒。
都是门徒。So, Ashu, 他早上讲课，七点。
对，阿叔明天早上七点的讲课，我不知道他会不会专门讲这个他们的 Krishna Goswami 的这个内容。
可能。Okay, so anyway,
好 ，good day。
所以今天我们讲到这儿。
对，是，太晚了。
Okay, 感谢方先生聆听提问，感谢慈悲的瑞普给我们翻译，感谢上帝主角，感谢所有的方先生，祝福你们生活快乐，注意安全，多保重身体，祝福你们健康。
Good day。对对，特别特别感恩您，然后您也要一定要保重身体，我们都为您祈祷，一切都顺利健康。
好，谢谢您的祝福 ，Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
Srila Prabhupada ki。
Jai。
Jai。
Go back to Vrinda ki。
Jai。